green. Seriously. The EU hit Britain with a £1.7 billion bill because our economy has done well. Those Europeans, they've got a bloody cheek. They even hand wrote on the bottom of the bill, service not included, smiley face. Having a check, a £1.7 billion bill. If ever there was a time when you'd thank your lucky stars you'd invested in a chain for your reading glasses, come back to that, yeah. Who had the tiramisu? I never had anyone, I know, I didn't even have a starter. That's pissed me right off. Did you see how angry Cameron was? Oh, he looked like Deborah Meaden being asked to invest in a shit-making factory. One of the candidates on this year's Apprentice is rumoured to have a sex tape out there. I just hope he took Viagra. I do. Who's to blame for the failure of this bloody mess? I'm going to bring my penis back into the boardroom, Lord Sugar. And it's not easy for a penis to pull a suitcase on wheels. Have you tried? But you could tell the bloke in the film was one of the apprentices when he climbed off the girl at the end and said, thank you for the opportunity. But I don't think Lord Sugar will be that bothered. You, let's face it, Nick Hewer has been pulling cum faces in the boardroom for the past 10 years, hasn't he? And finally, everyone's been gearing up for Halloween. Are you excited, Chatty Man audience? The bit that frightens me is those big piles of pumpkins suddenly appearing in supermarkets, isn't it? You turn an aisle and suddenly it's like you're being flash mobbed by Katie Price in a Hall of Mirrors, isn't it? Oh, the sound of screaming kids on my street last year. I mean, that's the last time I answer the doorbell without checking my dressing gown first. Something looks like they want a Percy Pig. What a lineup we have for you tonight. I'm so excited right now because for the first time in years, I've got Wood on my show. Yes, that's right, the hobbit hero of the Lord of the Rings. Elijah Wood is in the house. She's the sexiest thing to come out of Gogglebox since Leon tried on June's lingerie. And the supermodel who strutted her stuff on more catwalks than Sandra's had pot noodles. Yes, Naomi Campbell will be here later. And the incredible Paloma Faith will be performing right here. But first, it's time to chew the fat and battle the bulge with the tightest trousered host on telly. That's right, your Friday night starts right here. With the one, the only, Dermot O'Leary! Now, what can I get you to drink, love?
What are you having?
Well, Halloween punch!
Yes, sure!
Yeah, Halloween punch!
Yeah, are you a fan of Halloween?
Oh, yeah, yeah, I love Halloween. Yeah, since I was a kid. We used to do, you know, fancy dress, trick or treat, that kind of thing. Love it.
Oh, look at this, yeah. Yeah, there you go, my love. Now, we've got to talk about your new book, The Soundtrack to My Life.
Yes.
I spent all weekend reading it, and I loved it. I loved it. I enjoyed it up until,
oh man,
page 216.
Why? What? There's nothing sad about page 216.
Yeah, it is if you're Alan Carr, love. Let's have a look. Jonathan Ross is such a great broadcaster. Alongside the equally brilliant Graham Norton, he's the most accomplished talk show host of the past 20 years. typo. That is predicative text going on.
Well, you know,
Didn't even the paperclip turn up and go, why not try Alan Carr? All I'm saying is, if I win Best Chat Show Host at the National Television Awards...
Which I hope you do.
You better not grab it from me like Kanye did to poor Taylor Swift. Shit!
Do you know what it was? No, it was the fact that... So I got approached to do a book, and I wanted to do one, but I didn't really want to just do a kind of, like, isn't my story sort of book. No. So I wanted to tag it to music, because so every chapter has a song. Yeah. And it's not particularly... you don't have to like the song. The song just defines a certain period of your life. And that's what I did. So it was just... So when I wanted to get into television, Jonathan was you know, Jonathan and Terry Wogan were the two people I grew up watching that sort of made me wanted to get into telly in the first place. And I don't know what happened. With the Graham Norton thing, I do apologise.
Don't be so silly.
You know
we're
I love you.
Friends. I know. And we're actually going for dinner after tonight, are we?
That's true.
Because what I love about it is... Because you think, oh, it's going to be your favourite song. But it's not. And what I like the way you put it... Songs have chosen you,
yeah.
Almost.
Yeah, definitely. Because the whole point is, and I'm sure everyone has, like, you know, you're kind of the soundtrack of your life that you think to yourself, oh, that was the song I first fell in love to, or the first single you bought, yeah. And so forth. But a lot of these songs just appear, you know, because I'm not really a diary keeper or a journal keeper, so when I sat down to write it, it's amazing when you get going as to how many, what you do remember, and that those sort of little memories come out of nowhere, normally about 3 a.m, when you sort of wake up and go, oh, yeah, that guy at school, and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, yeah.
So me and my sister had, for example, my sister's responsible for the first single I bought, so that chapter's really about growing up in Colchester, but growing up sort of, you know, Irish in Colchester, and my sister... kidding or conning me into nicking my pocket money under the auspices that we'd co-own Wham's Young Guns Go For It. So she takes it, she goes to Andy's Records or Al Price or whoever, buys it, comes back, shows me it, and I never see it again. She just disappears with it and then shuts the door and then plays it on repeat again and again and again.
Oh, no,
it's heartbreaking. And she's a good sister, but that was it.
Yeah. But why does music... It's funny how music makes you think of something, because, like, you know, Pharrell's Happy?
Yeah.
That reminds me of when I lost my virginity.
Nice. Thanks for that, there. Was that a happy moment for you?
Oh, I was happy. Yes. I'm like a house without a roof. Well, there are so many great songs on the soundtrack. And you know how on X Factor they have Movie Week, yeah. Or 80s Week?
Well, and then Movie Week again.
Yes. They never have a Dermot Week, do they?
That would be quite surreal. But
well,
yes, they don't.
Well, I was thinking...
No, you were not.
I've asked some of the legends of X Factor to perform their favourite songs from your book live right here,
okay.
For you tonight.
OK.
You Friday night starts right here.
I don't talk like that.
Yeah, you do.
Do I talk like that?
Right, well, because opening the show for us tonight...
Yeah, go on.
...is the amazing Two Shoes.
Oh, I love Two Shoes.
Yeah, we all love
Two Shoes!
I always like the non-mental ones. Yeah!
What are you up to at the moment?
Oh, you know, Al, we're just loving life in Essex, keeping yeah. Busy, keeping out of trouble.
Oh, well. You're from Essex, you two.
Get
down the download, didn't you? We're giving up for Two Shoes, everyone. Weren't they lovely?
You two girls. Bye, Rose.
Thanks for doing that. So why was that on the soundtrack? I mean, I was surprised, like, the Macarena,
yeah.
I mean, all that, I mean, really? But, yeah.
First time a pilot I did in television, the way pilots sort of work is you do things again and again and again because they want to get it right. And you must, you know, have done pilots in your time. And so it sort of kills any kind of instinct, I suppose, because you do the same lines again and again. And I was a runner for a TV production company at the time. And I... And I remember cycling back to work the next day, and in my head I should be thinking, oh man, I've got this could be the next chance of my life. And all I'm thinking in my head is dabba 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 Macarena. Hey Macarena. Because the night before they'd booked Los Del Rio to finish the show. And so Los Del Rio came on, but because the director wanted to do it again and again and again and again, they did it again and again and again and again. So that's the next morning, all I'm thinking is, hey Macarena.
I know that is an annoying song, and I'd rather have tinnitus. I would. I would. I mean, you talk a lot in the book about the thrill of doing live telly.
Yeah.
Why do you enjoy it so much? Because, I mean, it is terrifying. Make a very hard job look easy.
Thank you. There's just...
It does, you know, because you're like... Bleh, bleh. Oh, well, I'm falling, you know what I mean?
I first started on T4, I threw up every Sunday morning.
You threw up?
Yeah, every single Sunday morning. I was so nervous about going on air. There we are, that's just after I've slept with Margarita. Thank you for sharing. and you just get used to it over a while. And now it's a weird thing to say, but the 30 seconds before the X Factor starts, you've got these big doors that just come out like that, and just, you know, loads
and
of lights
on. And that music hardly fit, makes you comfortable, isn't it? Dun, dun.
Exactly, yeah. And Peter Dixon kind of booms out, live from London, CX Factor, and here's your host. Those first 30 seconds are the most terrifying of the weekend. And then Holly Willoughby, when she first started, always says she was great. She turned around and she went, you're stood there for 30 seconds and you're looking around going, I don't want to do it. You do it, you do it, I don't want to do it. And so she put the sound on and go, I don't want to do it. And then as soon as the door goes back, you go, oh, no, hang on a second, this is what I do. And then you can really enjoy it.
Yeah, yeah.
I love it, though. There's something...
Halloween night.
Too,
oh. Do you know, there are... God.
Come on now. Mother's milk.
Yeah. Ask that man with no head who... Right, time for another performance, and up next is the brilliant... Johnny Robinson.
Here we go.
This town is coming like a ghost town. All the clubs have been closed down. This place. It's coming like a ghost town. Bands won't play no more. Too much fighting on the dance floor. Ay, 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 ay,
ay,
I waited that for ages.
Oh, do you know what? I found that truly haunting.
I bet you did. It was quite scary, wasn't it?
Yeah, so what are you up to, love?
Oh, well, I've been looking after my baby. I've had a baby, well, a dog.
Oh.
Yeah.
How the hell has that happened? That's what I was thinking.
Exactly. I've got a Staffordshire Bull Terrier called Bobby Dazzler, and he's two in December, the same day as my birthday.
Oh, what a lovely thing.
Thank you. Lovely to see you, Dermot. Thank you.
Hey, you won't get knocked down, will you,
Mum? No,
no. Thanks for coming, love. Johnny Robinson.
Let me say that. I love the fact that when you ask Johnny to say what he's up to plugging wise, you know, it's quite nice to give him a plug.
Yeah.
I've got a dog. Bless him for that. I love that.
Yeah, because normally I've got an album.
He's going to get backstage. His management's going to be, why didn't you mention a single? He's like.
Mind you, some of the megastars you have on X Factor, when you say to them at the end of the performance, when is your album out? The half of them that don't even know.
Tell me about it.
I mean, some of them are like, what album?
I know.
You've got all that, you've got costume changing.
I think I said to Brittany once when she came on, I said, listen, I know you've met Arak, so who are your favourites? And she went, I'm really enjoying being in London and I'm having a marvellous time. And I was like, no, I didn't ask you that at all. At all.
I mean, how do you feel, obviously, when reading your book and everything about all the lovely music you like? I mean, there must be a little pang in there when someone comes on and murders a really good
song. I
did
Born to Run a few years ago, a guy called Storm Lee, and Storm was a very nice chap. But quite often on The X Factor, we have to trim songs down, so because... Yeah, 14, 15 people or whoever performing. So you can't do 4.5 minutes. I remember Storm, and certain songs you just can't really trim down, can you? And poor Storm had to do Born to Run. And I remember just walking on stage afterwards going, yeah! Yeah. Inside going, oh my God, what have they done to my baby?
But it must hurt though if someone like that. I mean, can we talk about last week's sing off?
It wasn't great.
I mean, what was going on? It was like everyone's balls had dropped at the same moment.
Look, I think, in all seriousness, I think we were quite honest about... I mean, Simon just called it there and then. He said it was the worst sing-off he'd ever heard.
Yeah, yeah.
What I would say in mitigation is the nerves and the adrenaline and you know, they get to rehearse and, put, and you know, they choreograph all week to do one performance and then suddenly it's like, right, you're in the bottom two, which is, you know...
Oh, I know, horrible, isn't it?
Exactly, horrible as it is. And they've got to sing for your life. On you go. And that's a big test of character for people. And you know, obviously, they. I know only the young one would be happy with theirs, and I don't think Jake was either.
No, no. And surely Andrea's going to win.
He is...
Surely he's going to win. It's just
I don't know if he's going to win, because he's a balladeer, and so, obviously, as the weeks go on, he has different kind of challenges.
Rock week.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, this week, I know he's got quite an up-tempo number, for example. Yeah. So if he gets through this week... he's obviously very popular. People are always talking about him.
Yeah.
He is the nicest guy. He's so happy all the time. He's, we use the word amazing. Like, whenever you speak to him, we're like, Andrea, you're amazing. I'm enjoying it so much.
He's sweet sat,
yeah, he's a real sweetheart.
I'm glad that, because if you'd come on here and said, you know, he's vile, he's throwing, like, scalding hot tea in people's face, fuck off. He puts that on. Can you imagine if he puts all that on? Wouldn't
you
be gutted? OK, it's time for the last performance of the night.
Brilliant.
In your book, you talk about some of the best performances you've had on X Factor. And one of them was Lady Gaga singing Bad Romance.
It was great.
Oh.
I'm very excited.
Sadly, Lady Gaga can't be here tonight,
that's
but don't worry.
OK.
You're well, in for a treat.
Good.
Singing Bad Romance. It's the one, the only. Wagner!
I want your drama, the touch of your hand. I want your leather studded kiss in the sand. I want your love. Love, 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 I want your love.
All over again.
Yeah, what a pleasure.
Oh,
well, great to see you. Yes, thank you very much.
Look at this.
Wow. Still got that lion? Remember that little lion? That lion you had?
No, I don't have the lion anymore. I have Caucasian shepherds now.
Caucasian shepherds.
Oh, massive dogs.
Oh. And what else are you up to at the moment?
Oh, I'm...
Have you got any music coming out?
Yes,
we want to hear this, don't we?
Right, no music. I lie awake at night, I can't sleep. I'm switched on like the radio. I keep picturing your face, it's so sweet. Make me feel high when I am so low. I lie awake at night, I can't sleep. I'm switched on like the radio.
Yes, I see.
That is a plug.
Yeah,
that is a plug. Why plug it when you can sing it? We're just into, and you've also got, you got a tanning salon, is that right?
Oh, no, 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 I like drawing, so I sometimes I tattoo in King's Winford.
You sometimes do tattooing, do you know, we like
sometimes.
A part-time tattooist, oh. What could go wrong?
Oh, I love you, you
back
oh.
Yeah. Oh, good luck with everything. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye bye,
everybody.
Oh. A part-time
Where is that? Now that is a character.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much for coming on the show, Dermot Love.
Oh my God, don't be serious. I had a great time. Are we not? Is that it? Are we not going to talk more?
A lot of that time has been taken up by the X Factor legends. which songs aren't available in any shops anytime soon. Thank you. Good luck with the book.
Dermot O'Leary, everyone.
After break, Naomi Campbell, Elijah Wood and Paloma Faith will be here. I'll see you in part two. Faith will be here soon. First, though, go nuts, go wild, and wave your rings in the air like you just don't care. For the Baggins behind the biggest blockbusters in box office history, it's the brilliant Elijah Wood!
Each other in years.
I know,
it's
I know.
Been, I think, maybe seven.
Yeah,
seven
now, do you
years
remember the show that we worked on
the
together?
Friday Night Project?
No way.
Yes way.
I bet you Wikipedia'd that.
No, I remember.
Oh!
And you had my my friends Eloise and the Savoir Faire as the band that night as well.
Yes, yes.
That
oh my
awesome.
God, what a blast from the past.
Oh, no.
Right, let me. Do you want some punch?
I would love some.
It's alcoholic, you're right.
Brilliant, yeah, yeah, lovely. What is it? What's in it?
I have no idea.
Great.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, I like the mug as well. It's a little skull glass. It's fantastic.
Oh, it's good, isn't it? There you go. And do you know what? Because it's Halloween, I'll pop a couple of dead spiders in it.
Oh, oh, that's fantastic.
I know. Is this scary?
It's very scary. A little scared. Didn't know what it is.
Oh, look at this.
Is it nice?
Yeah, it's lovely.
Oh, good, it's good. A fruit punch.
Oh, you know, you're probably one of the first people on this show that's had something out of this globe and went, that's nice. It is full of shit.
Yeah,
it's very, very sweet.
Yeah,
very
I feel
sweet.
My veneers just falling off. The thing is, you know, you Americans, yeah, you
yeah.
cream your drawers for Halloween.
Yeah, we love
you?
It, yeah.
You, no, they don't. England, yeah, in England, we just used to, like, wear a sheet with, like, two eyes cut out.
Right.
And go around, woo, like that. You dress up, don't you? You go.
Really
mental.
Do it, yeah. And we trick-or-treat. Do you trick-or-treat here?
Well, no, you started all that out as well.
But isn't it funny, because I think it actually started here and then somehow took off and became its own thing in the US.
Yeah.
And now we've influenced you all again and you're actually doing it.
I know.
Have you ever been trick-or-treating?
Well, you see, you can't really in London, do you know what I mean? Because I'm right. not being rude, but yeah. people, like, get, like, you know, for, like, an iPhone. So if you're not going,
thanks.
I know, yeah. Right, okay. It's a pretty okay. brave person to go, do you know what? I think I'll have a trick. You know what? It's best just to go, ah, Percy Pigs, Haribo, just fuck off. Because you're a big fan of horror films,
I
aren't
am,
you?
Yeah, I love
now,
horror
Now, which
films.
Ones do you like? Do you like the slasher ones or do you like the psychological doo
I like all of them. I like the psychological ones. Yeah. I like the gory films. I kind of, as a fan of horror, I like it all.
Yeah.
But my favorite films are things like The Exorcist.
Oh.
Or The Thing. Movies that kind of take the subject matter seriously. And The Exorcist is so terrifying because it feels like it could be real.
Yeah.
As opposed to it being, you know.
That's the ones I like where they sort of F with your head. Do you know what
yeah,
I
yeah,
mean?
Yeah.
I like those ones where, oh my God, there's a noise in the basement. I might just go down there with no clothes on and. I won't put the light on, though, because that would be silly.
Yeah.
Talking of films, we've got to talk about your new one, mm. Set Fire to the Stars.
Yes.
And it's as far away from Bride of Chucky as it could be, and it's like...
Yes.
...beautifully shot, black and white film about Dylan Thomas.
Yes.
And obviously a lot of our audience know who Dylan Thomas is.
Of course they do.
Yeah. But... Yes. Yes, thank you. Yes. But to the people at home who can't read, just explain. he was a fantastic poet, wasn't he? But he was a pisshead.
Yeah. He was a Welsh poet. Right. He sort of had a reputation for, you know, sort of a rousing drinker. Had a massive personality. Was sort of explosive. Loved to yeah. carouse with people and have, you know, intense conversations. And sort of, he was uncontrollable in some ways.
Yeah.
And so the film is about... Dylan Thomas come to the United States for the first time, and he's brought over by this guy called John Malcolm Brennan, who was a poet and a poetry professor who I play, and he kind of gets a lot more than he bargained for and ends up having to sort of babysit him.
Yeah, well, yeah. There's a bit where you pull back the sheets and he's...
And he's soiled himself. Yeah.
And we've all done that, though, haven't we?
Ah!
Yeah! Anyway, awkward. We've got a little clip now. This is Elijah babysitting a very tipsy Dylan Thomas in Set Fire to the Stars.
So, 4 days ago, I thought I was a professor of poetry in New York. Now? Not so sure. Benefactor, babysitter, nurse baby. Oh,
Jesus, you made it sound like a marriage.
Like you and Shirley, huh?
I wouldn't go that far. There was a crucial difference, my boy.
Oh?
Shirley needs me.
Come on, Harry's. Get up. Your turn.
No, I don't... No, kill it,
come on. Come on. America versus Wales. Put him up. Come on. Put your hands up, John. That's right. Come on, John. Try a bit harder. Put him up. John, try harder. Come on. Yes. Come on.
Did you do your own stunts?
I did, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Was it all right?
Yeah, fantastic. Now, the last Hobbit film's out in December.
Yes.
How are you feeling about the old Middle-earth thing coming to an end?
It's funny, because for me, it's come to an end many times.
You're not in the last one, though.
I'm not in the last
no.
one. And so I've kind of said goodbye to Middle-earth multiple times at the end of the Rings trilogy and then going back on the first Hobbit and reprising the role, which I never thought I would do, and having that kind of sense of closure again. And so the fact that it's all kind of coming to an end, it feels significant. I think it probably feels very significant to Peter and to the people that kind of took the journey on this that have been working on it for 4 years. And I actually genuinely believe that this is probably the last time...
Are you sure? Because they said that about Police Academy.
And then we also said it about Middle Earth years ago, and they've gone back. So, who knows? Maybe we'll see this similarly. Yeah. But, I'm excited to see the film.
Yeah. What are the rap parties like on these big Hollywood films? You get, like, people getting off with orcs and dwarves and stuff. Drunk fueled, is it all like that, you know? Everyone gets pissed and stuff, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It depends on the film, but Lord of the Rings, our rap party, I think, was about 2,000 people. Because there were, like, 2,000 people
course,
that worked
course,
on
yeah,
the films.
Yeah, of course. I mean, when you work in an office, yeah, you nick sort of stationery, don't you? You know, the rap party. Have you nicked anything from Hobbit or anything, Lord of the Rings?
I have a lot of things from those films.
Really?
Yeah.
What did you nick?
I have a map that was in Bag End. I have Bilbo's book that he was writing.
Oh, really?
I have the ring. I have... I have Sting, the sword.
Yeah.
And I have a pair of feet.
Hobbit feet.
Hobbit feet, yeah.
Oh, that must be nice on a Sunday.
You know, just slip those on.
If I didn't nip into the shop to get a pint of milk. Oh, where's me old sodic? Elijah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
When is Set Fire to the Stars out?
November 7th.
November 7th. And thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
And you're on. Don't leave it for long next time.
I won't.
Naomi Campbell and Paloma Faith will be here. See you in part three. Welcome back. Paloma Faith will be performing later. First, though, give it up for the Streatham girl who strutted away to supermodel stardom before slumping herself on the Gogglebox sofa. It's the amazing Naomi Campbell!
How are you, Alan?
Oh, the better for seeing you. Look at that outfit!
Halloween!
Oh, happy Halloween!
Happy Halloween. Happy Halloween.
Right, let me get you a drink. I've got Yakko, I've got... What's that pinky one?
It's got alcohol in it.
No, big spice tomato juice. Do you like it?
No. Okay. Ginger ale.
Ginger ale?
Ginger ale's great.
Okay.
Yeah.
About where was it?
Thank you.
Oh, yes. Let me get that going for you.
Very nice. I didn't offer drinks on Chatty Man.
Oh, yeah. My God. Everyone just comes in here, gets pissed. We'll be having a kebab.
I have to say,
yes.
What you did on Stand Up for Cancer was amazing. You were there.
Oh,
this week. Seat sitting on the stage with you, then you're running back and doing all that stuff backstage with the boxes and going in the bathrooms.
I know.
And no wonder you came back drenched.
Well, I was so I'm fat. That's what happened.
And the gym. Listen, you must have lost 2 kilos doing that.
Oh, well, I know. And the trouble is, I was getting these under here. Do you know what I mean? It was like W. Sure, I'm like, whoa. People, one of my implants had leaked, honestly.
No, but it was such an honour to be part of that, and thank you.
Oh, well, you are so sweet for saying that. Thank you, my love.
Sweet doesn't go with Naomi, but anyway.
No, no.
Thank you.
There you go. Cheers.
Happy Halloween.
And also, while we're at it, I've got to say thank you to the audience as well. I mean, they raised £15.5 million. So give yourselves a round of applause. If you haven't donated yet, then go to www.channel4.com/SU2C. Yeah, and find out how to get involved. Wonderful. Right. Cheers, love.
Cheers.
Right, now listen.
Tell me. You did
Celebrity Gogglebox.
Yeah, it was great.
Oh, my God. It was so much fun. How does that even happen? Who approached who?
I don't know. Kate called me and said, did you get the call? I'm like, yes. Yeah. She goes, we're doing it. She's like, Noel's with us, and we're like, that's it. And, just to be, three of us just chilling in the living room.
Oh, I know. It's great, isn't it? Yeah, it was so funny. Did you see it? Yes.
What did you think? Did you like it?
I mean, do you normally sit there watching telly like that? Do you sit there like we do in leggings, poncho, eating Monster Mansion?
I'll be honest, I don't get to sit always in a living room. I usually sit on planes.
Okay,
so yeah. I, like, kind of download everything.
Okay, yeah.
And I watch it on the plane when I'm travelling. Yeah. And, I mean, when I'm home, to sit home in front of the TV is a major luxury for me.
Well, let's have a look at a clip. This is Naomi, Kay and Noel trying to answer Jeremy Paxson's questions on University Challenge.
The name of which genre of popular music may be expressed as the joint of the body that includes the acetabulum plus the flower of...
Hip-hop! Acid house.
Hip. Hip-hop.
Hip-hop.
Hip-hop? Correct.
Yes.
Fine, shush, carry on.
So what happened when the camera stopped rolling? Did Kate, like, twat your back? Oh, yeah, you get the London look.
It was an accident. It was my sister. You know, it was all real. I was shocked. I always thought to myself, I'll never get the questions right at University Challenge. It's going to be the hardest one yet of all the segments. I didn't do too bad.
I know. University Challenge. I don't even bother watching
that. It just scares
me.
The name.
Like a moron,
the name just scares me. It's just like, oh, I don't know.
Well, I don't even understand the questions, let alone the answer.
Well, you know what was so funny when they're like, they're like looking around like this, quite like, well, what is it? And we're like, it's Aretha Franklin. But it's great fun.
I mean, you're also doing, what's this pop up shop? A charity.
Oh,
now,
yes.
Can I just say about pop up shops?
What do you think about them?
They frighten the shit out of me. They pop up from nowhere. You're walking along and then it's like a boot.
I don't mind that. Mystery.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
What are you going to find in there? Like, just I like that kind of pop-up stores. They have good, great things, like limited things, eclectic things. If you're, if you're a collector, it's great pop-up stores.
And you're doing a charity one, aren't you?
I'm doing a charity pop-up store, and it's Fashion for Relief, which is my charity.
Yeah.
It will be for Fashion for Relief Crush Ebola. Because this is something I think we need to take seriously.
Yeah.
So that opens on the 27th of November in Westfields.
All right. And will you be there, man in the tails?
I will be.
How much was there?
I've done it before and I'll do it again. And, don't forget, I used to work in Topshop when I was younger.
Oh, really?
Yeah, loved it.
And you're also doing a charity fashion show. Are you catwalking?
I will do, amongst as many other amazing people. Like, everyone's just, you know, when it comes to doing something for that, everyone just comes together. So we've had Boy George on the runway, Vivian Westwood on the runway. Oh. It's a collaboration of everyone making it happen. So it's not just me, it's we come together.
Do you need a male model?
We asked you, and you said yes. So you're going
to
say no?
I'd love to do it!
Oh, they're done, dear.
Because you're
not getting your witness today.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Because the thing is, you know. Because if you notice now, we're marvelling. You've got Lara Stone, and remember the Jagger girl? Got a London look, her. They've all got teeth like mine.
Honey.
This is my time. This is my moment. I would love to do. I would so love to be a catwalk
model. Okay, I need to tell
model.
You something. You
yeah.
need to know this.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's important you need to know this. I was always told that anyone that has a gap in their tooth is extremely lucky person. You have that gap.
Oh.
And also it means a lot of money for you.
Oh, I know, well, that's true.
So
yeah.
then look what you're worried about.
I mean, but this is okay.
Enjoy it, darling. Enjoy it.
Oh, I never thought. Because I've done a little bit of modelling before. You know Aunt Bessie? You know Aunt Bessie? I modelled. Oh, well, it's the woman who makes Yorkshire puddings and roast thing. And I used to model for him like this. So look, this will ring a few bells. That's what she looks like. But she had a bun. Do you remember she had a bun? Do you remember the bun?
I'm not actually in that Yorkshire pudding.
Oh. You don't eat Yorkshire pudding.
I do.
Because I was surprised on Gogglebox you got get those old Monster Munch.
I was loving. And I had Monster Munch, I had Twiglets, I had Percy Pigs. There's a lot of stuff there.
Oh, my God, mm-hmm. I didn't think it.
I do eat my junk now and again.
Let's talk about supermodels, yeah?
Yeah.
That word gets bandied around, but you were the original. You, Christy Turlington, wasn't it? Cindy Crawford, Linda Vagina Blister. You were...
Oh, you're naughty.
Was that
naughty?
That was her name, wasn't it? You were the originals, weren't you? I mean, do you think modelling's got easier now? Because, do you know what, you've got all the airbrushing now and all that. And you're, you know, when you started, you didn't have that. You had to be good, gorgeous looking.
Well, you know, now it's digital. And when I started, it was photographic and film and still printing and processing. I tend to, when I'm working, not look at the... They say, do you want to look at what you just did? I don't want to. It's the element of surprise that keeps me still...
Yeah.
Looking forward and enthusiastic.
Yeah. Well, you haven't changed, though, have you? I mean, I was looking at a picture of you. You have not bloody changed. You have not. Look, this is, I don't know how many years ago this was. Look at this. You have not changed. Look. Do you ever look at pictures of yourself and go, four?
Not often.
I'll give a one, eh, lads? Would you ever do that?
Oh, no. Not really, but I don't really look at, you know, something's coming out, I look at it for a minute and I'm on to the next, you know?
Oh, good. Yeah.
But I appreciate it. I appreciate everyone's effort and work and collaboration and making that picture happen. You know, I want to do something else. I want to, you know, I love to be transformed. Yeah.
Do you ever have minging days? You know, when you wake up and you've got, like, oh, a cold sore or, like, athlete's foot or something? And you're like... I mean, do you ever have... Because I can't imagine you.
Of course I get days where I feel, like, down and low and not feeling well
yes.
and staying in bed and hot water bottle. Absolutely. Oh. But I actually like those days.
Yeah, yeah. I saw that wake-up call selfie you did on Twitter. Now, do you really get out of bed like this?
Yeah.
I mean, look at that.
That's just light. Yeah. That's just light.
Because, you know, the thing is, I sleep with my two red setters. So if I, you know, they're saying, oh, do a wake-up selfie, I can't because, you know, with
You've
the ginger heads in the bed, it'll look like I've shagged Bonnie Langford
or something.
Are they sleeping in the bed with you? Yeah, yeah. I think I'm shagging that man from Homeland. You'll just get the back of his head.
I used to love Bonnie Langford.
Well, she's still alive.
Well, I know. Just William. What are they called? Just William, right?
I
loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we've got to take a break there, my love.
Why?
Oh, well, listen, we've got all part four to have a chin wag, love. Have a bit of ginger ale.
Thank
we'll
you.
Talk to you in a
Thank
minute.
You.
Join us again in a couple of minutes when I'll be chatting some more with Naomi and the brilliant Paloma Faith will be performing. See you in part four. Paloma Faith will be performing shortly, but look who's still here! It's only Naomi Campbell. Do you want a top up or are you all right, love?
I wouldn't mind a top up, actually.
Okay, of course.
Thank you. I actually really love ginger ale.
Now, listen, what's this program you're doing in America? Empire.
Empire. Okay, yeah. Let me have a quick sip. Oh. Empire is a show with the amazing director Lee Daniels, who did The Butler, Monsters Ball, Halle Berry.
Precious.
Yes, yes. He's amazing. It's with Terrence Howard, who's amazing.
Oh,
actor,
I love him, yeah.
And Taraji Henson, who won a Benjamin Button, an Oscar for Benjamin Button. And it's about the music industry, and my name is Camilla. Oh, and I don't want to say too much about my character. I'm British, and I like my boys. That's all I can say.
You like your boys?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
that's what Camilla says.
Oh, so you like a bit of a wrong'un.
Like my boys. That's all I'm going to tell you.
Oh, okay.
And I can't tell you more than that.
Because actually, you know, when you think about it, modelling is a bit like acting, really, because I've got a friend who works for QVC, yeah.
Yeah.
And she's there, like, rubbing this facial cream in for about 4 hours.
No,
and
that,
she's going,
that is acting, I agree with you.
I know, she's going, oh, wow, look at this. You know, he's like fruit of the jawbone. Like.
I do agree. I agree with you. For me, it's, I mean, it's just a great opportunity and something new that I want to try. And so I've been given this opportunity, so I'm going to do it the best I can.
Oh, of course, of course. Now, you're good at, like, learning lines.
It's not about the lines so much. It's about getting the real whole arc of the scene and what the message is that they're trying to get through. So I try to go on that. And then once you get that, then the lines will just come automatically.
All right, I see.
Going into your truth, they call it.
Oh, really?
You know what? I think it's very therapeutic in a way.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I bet, yeah. No, it is. I bet it is. Because you know what I'd like to see you in? A period drama. You know, like Downton Abbey. Wouldn't you like to see? I bet you'd even look sexy in a bonnet like this. I bet. I mean, could you maybe just have a little look to see how pretty...
Is this Downton Abbey or Little House on the Prairie? I'm not quite sure. Now, which is this, the back or the front?
Oh, let me, please.
Is the front?
Well, listen, I've been a costumier for years.
Oh, my.
Oh, you look pretty as a picture. Look at that. Oh, wow.
Well, you have a cute bonnet. Now, is this what you're wearing now? Are you trick-or-treating tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to a party. Do you know what I'm going as?
Who?
Liberace.
Oh, that's so easy.
Too easy,
so easy.
He's dead. What?
No, that is just way too easy. Pick someone else.
I've got the costume also.
Let's go. That's just way too easy, Alan. I'm sorry.
Why is it way too easy? Because I'm gay? Because I'm gay?
No!
I'm going there.
Don't you dare go there. No, it's because it's just a ruffled shirt and some bloody rings and fur. That's what it is. And a quiff. That's the river, aren't
you? Listen, you try and get a quiff out of this. Thank you. Good luck of Empire.
Thank you so
and
much.
And please let me know about that catwalk, because I've never catwalked before.
February.
It would be a dream. February.
20th, the week of the 20th.
Oh, I am there. Thank you. Well. The one and only Naomi Campbell, everyone! That's it for tonight's show. A massive thank you to Dermot O'Leary, Elijah Wood, and, of course, Naomi Campbell. Show, I'll be joined by the mind-bendingly brilliant Darren Brown, the Great British Bake Off, Sue Perkins, and the very funny Nina Conti. But now we're ready for the good life. It's Paloma Fan!